I want to share with you three methods that I've personally found helpful when it comes to dealing with being triggered. Number one, I like to tell myself that in these moments, the person that is saying or doing these things, and if I'm being honest, it's usually a friend or a family member, that they're doing it not intentionally, right? They don't intend to trigger me. It's just kind of my response to the stimuli. Again, being totally honest, there's many times where this isn't enough and I'm still thinking, how could they do or say that thing? Okay, so number two, I think it's important to know what's happening to the body when being triggered. When we're seeing red, we're responding in a way that we'd refer to as a sympathetic response. And what this means is instinctually, the nervous system is taking over and we're treating this as a life or death, fight or flight type moment. So it helps to remind myself that, hey dummy, you're being triggered right now. This isn't a moment that requires a life or death type response. And that slows me down long enough to kind of get my logic, my ability to reason back. Number three, it helps knowing triggers are these road signs, these markers of past pains and experiences that are making us hypersensitive to something that's being said right now. Doing this does a few things. Well, number one, I no longer need to go out and try to control the other person and what they're saying because that would be impossible, right? I can't control someone else. And second, I don't need to go and remove myself from every environment where I might be triggered because that would mean I'd pretty much have to stay home and just become a hermit. But instead, this reframing of a trigger actually gives myself the ownership and the control back. I have the power to then go and resolve that past issue, that past trauma that's making me hypersensitive to this thing. And when I do this, once that thing is resolved, the trigger is no longer a trigger. Hopefully this helps. We'd love for you to subscribe to the podcast and follow for more tips.